last century. If you look how the level of the sea rise in this period, or the reduction of ice, continental ice, and also Arctic ice in the last 30, 50, 70 years, it's quite clear. There is no doubt about it. And this is the reason because the scientists all together say that the climate is changing, no way. In this case, you may also look on the change of concentration of CO2. We have records in the last 800,000 years. And it's quite clear, again, that the change of concentration was more or less this way, going between glacial and interglacial era. And then sometime we discover oil under the soil, we start to use oil, and the concentration was a double than it was before, almost a double. And again, it's a confirmation that this change is not connected with the normal variation of the climate, but it's connected with the increase of GHG, greenhouse gas, in the atmosphere. We need to keep simple the information without losing the scientific detail. So it's really challenging also for the journalist to be on the topic, to be precise, but at the same time to be understandable by the other people. Because we have scientific scientists speaking on the microphone, and it's not possible to understand anything. It's not the point. They are perfectly right. They say perfect things, but they are not going, they're not giving the message to the audience. I may tell you the story about Italy. And 20 years ago, 50 years ago, the level of awareness, the interest of the normal people, the normal citizen, was quite low, and there was no interest to follow the news on climate change. And now the situation has changed. There is a lot more people asking information and looking in internet, in different blogs, looking for information to be more. Receive more updated information on it. The adaptability, as you say, have two different meanings. One meaning is very important already now, because we need to adapt to climate change. Climate is already changing now, and we need to adapt to this changing to reduce the impact that we will suffer in the present and the future. The other side of the adaptation, or how people may adapt to climate change, is the perception, is the feeling, is how people may perceive the change. And this is a very dangerous situation, because you know, I use the example of the trees. And when you see one tree that is cut, you recognize the change. You are shocked sometimes. But you are not able the same way to understand how the tree is growing day by day. And you discover after 5 years, for example, you say, oh, how big is this tree now? And this is the situation where the change is going with you. And you lose the memory how the situation was in the past. And I had a very interesting example of some children in a project that we are doing in Italy that was asking to the grandparents how the situation was at that time. And it was really interesting because When the children spoke with the grandfather, they discovered the situation was completely different. The number of days with ice, with snow, in the mountain was a little more. So, but this case, this example, was explaining how you need to have a long distance of time to perceive the change. The growth is a word that have a bad perception with the normal people, because we need always to think about that this is not a part of a community. It's something that we need to solve at the global level. We need to have all people involved in this process. So I try to avoid to use the word the growth. I stay in the same concept maybe. I want to avoid the word the growth. What I want to say is that we need to be more conscious about the implication of our action, the implication of our consumption, the implication of what we eat day by day. So if this implication means that we need to use a little bit less energy, less material, and to have different choices in the food, in the normal choice of the food, I think it's something that we need to do in the next years. In the, also for now, I have to say. A lot of companies are already investing time and resources and money in direction of reduction of GHG emission, greenhouse gas emission. There are two main areas. One is the GHG inventory, so it means the inventory of the emission of the organization, and the other one is the carbon footprint of products, to be aware about the content of CO2. The CO2 is embedded in the product because maybe it's connected with the raw material or with other phases of the life cycle of the product. So the level of awareness is growing, also the direction, but it's not enough. We need to involve more companies, and we need to move as consumer to give pressure to the producer, because it's a game that need to have two players. It's not possible to expect that only one player may solve the problem. So we need to work together, consumer and the producer. And then, but you mentioned also the policymakers, and the politicians are a crucial point, a crucial responsibility. For example, the choice on energy, to promote the production of renewable energy instead of to use coal production. So the choice is on the table. And now the politicians have to decide yes or not. There are two, three different questions in your point. The first one is the change from shall to should, I think was the right word. It was fundamental because this change permit Obama to accept the Paris Agreement without go through the Senate, because it was not an international agreement, it was different level of legislation. It was very important how one word may change the future of an agreement. But the other point that you mentioned was about Trump. We know that he said that he wants to go out from the Paris Agreement. And now we need to see what will happen, because you know, he said they want to go out, but he needs 4 years to go out. Or he should withdraw USA from United Nations Framework for Climate Change, UNFCCC. I believe it will be very difficult. So we need to see what's happened will happen in the next year. I have to say also that the situation, the reaction of the USA from the decision of Trump is unbelievable. For the first time, the awareness of USA citizens is very, very high on climate change. And now we have governor, they have major, you have business. Everybody is claiming we want to stay on the Paris Agreement. Okay, I have to underline that I'm not a scientist. So I'm a journalist, and I try to transfer the information that I have from the science. And the science says that the worst scenario is to stay as we are, the business as usual. We stay in our comfortable position, and we will wait that at the end of the century we will have 4 degrees more than the normal. 4 degrees is a lot. You know, now we are around 1 degree, the situation is very bad in several parts of the world. So 4 degrees will be very the worst scenarios. And the best scenarios is to stay in 1.5 according to the Paris Agreement. It's really, really difficult to achieve the 1.5. Probably we will go in direction of 2.0 if possible. But now, in this moment, also with the Paris Agreement, we are in direction 2.7. We need to realize that there is no one action. There is no one solution. There is one commitment able to work on different areas. We need to change drastically the transportation system. It's not possible that we grow the number of street, grow the number of car, always with more powerful car on the street, consuming a lot of gasoline, soil, air transportation, etc., etc. So we really need to rethink about the system. I give an example. 30, 40 years ago in Italy, all the city had a beautiful, intensive, extensive system of tram transportation. And they decided to remove, to give space to the car. And now all the measure, they may become crazy to have the opportunity to have tram back again. So now we have to reverse the process. And we need to transfer this concept to all the world, also to developing countries. So we need to have very solid public transportation system. We need to give space to the bicycle for the small distance transportation. We need to rethink about the system we use to move the goods through the countries. And this is only for the mobility system. And then we need to move to the energy production. And then the answer is quite easy. We know that we need to move a lot more in the direction of the renewable energy. And we may use incentive, we may use carbon tax, we may use different tools, but the final result is the same. We need to facilitate the growth on the renewable energy. And then we need to work in the direction of efficiency, because we need to consume less energy, absolutely a lot less energy than we are using today, but not going back in the old age where people suffer in an uncomfortable world, but to have an efficient way where it's very good to live. Our house often are some kind of car box losing energy. We need to insulate more the house, we need to keep the energy inside to save energy. Again, so it's energy efficiency. And then we have food. We always forget food, but food has an important role. And we need to think about what we are eating and when we are eating something. So when the provenience of the raw material, but also we think about which kind of place we give to the meat. I don't want to be too strong in this direction. I don't want to say we need to become all vegetarian, but we need to eat less meat. And we need to eat less meat from cow. So, I see a very happy world in the future. Not people frustrating and suffering, but people that is working together in direction to fight climate change and looking how it's possible to improve the world to have a better life.